What is going on, everybody? It's Nothing But Skills, and in today's video, we're going to be talking about some huge changes coming to the Division II. And when I talk about huge changes, I talk about Title Update 10. Now, during the state of the game, they gave us a lot of different news about what changes we can expect coming to Title Update 10. But if you're on PC, there is a PTS coming. Listen.
Fresh news from half an hour ago. The PTS is starting on Friday. Am I correct, Yannick?
Yes. Yes, that is correct.
Cool. The preload will be available tomorrow, Thursday, at 6 o'clock CEST. So 25 hours from now, or 24 hours and 51 minutes from now, that will be available for people. If you own the game on PC, you'll be able to get it through Uplay, and the servers will open at 2 o'clock Friday afternoon.
Now, I know a lot of people are going to say, man, I wish there was a PTS on console, but I addressed this in the last video I made for the Division 2. When I talked about why they don't do PTS on console, it's more due to Sony and Microsoft taking a longer time to verify the patch so that they can then bring this to you guys. So let's talk about some of the changes that they said that we'll be able to test during the PTS. First things first is the PTS is going to be in two phases, so we're going to have phase one and phase two. So a lot of the changes I'm going to tell you about right now are going to be changed in phase one. And then I will mention one thing that they said they're going to be working on during phase two. So let's talk about a couple things off the bat. They said that legendary missions are going to be more rewarding. They're going to increase the loot drop chance from veteran and elite enemies. There will be no purple loot in higher difficulty. You guys know when you guys do those control points, if you do them on heroic, every time you open up those little boxes inside the area that you get the yellow box, right, at the very end of completing it, you always tend to get some purple items. Not always, but a lot of times. So they are removing those small boxes, and they're going to put all the loot that would have came out of those small boxes in the big yellow box, and everything will scale together. So that is another way that they are improving the loot quality that we're going to be getting in Title Update 10. They also discussed the vendors, because that increases the type of loot we get, right? So they want to buff the vendors, because right now I stopped doing vendor reset videos because there really isn't anything worth getting. Sometimes you can get a named item, but they're always horribly rolled. But Casey Mendoza tends to have the better items if you ever do buy something, right? But if you go to the DZ vendors, if you go to the regular vendors, those vendors completely suck. But they are going to buff that. And not only that, they are going to be adding named items to all the vendors, plus the DZ vendors will also have named items. And what that means is, if you just want to go into DZ and farm those DZ resources, then you'll be able to purchase those named items. And then another good thing is, say if you're not the type to farm the DZ because you always get ganked, but you can go in there and get DZ resources, well, you can use those DZ resources to go purchase named items, and they will even have DZ specific named items in those DZ vendors. So if you've been looking for a DZ Dark Zone specific item and you haven't been able to get it, this is probably gonna be your best chance to get it in Title Update 10. So they're gonna be adding that to the PTS so we can test that out. Also, another really cool thing that they mentioned was weekly Shade Reward Project. They are bringing that back and making it more powerful than ever. Now you can get one exotic cache from the weekly Shade Project, and that will be once a week. And then also there'll be another way for you to get an exotic from the legendary. There's going to be a legendary weekly project, which will also reward you one exotic cash too. So a lot of different ways for you guys to get these exotics. And I know a lot of you guys are going to say, I was watching the chat, oh man, exotics aren't even worth it. They're adding different ways to get exotics, but at the end of the day, they're not even that good. The good thing about this is in Title Update 10, on phase two, this is on phase two, they are going to be looking at those exotics, making some small changes to make them more worthwhile. And I agree with you guys 100%. They feel underpowered, and there are a lot of different changes, even small changes, that will make them feel more rewarding to use and not have so much negative versus positive, right? Because right now, if you use exotic, there's a couple positives, but there's a lot more negatives to it, so then it's not even worth using. And in Title Update 10, hopefully, that's where they are going to address this. They also did add field proficiency caches are going to be coming back. Yes, they're going to be coming back. So you know how we have our season. So we have season one, season two is coming up soon. So in season one, once you get to 100, you never get season rewards anymore. Well, they're going to add field proficiency caches after that. So we'll be getting field proficiency caches after you complete 100. So once you get to level 100 of your season pass, well, season track, then you'll be able to get field proficiency caches. So those will be back. So another way for you guys to get some good loot. Like I said, PTS is going to be in phase one. That starts Friday. So Friday is PTS one. And then phase two is going to be shortly after. And then depending on their feedback, the changes they need to do, that's what they'll either drop Title Update 10 or they'll make some changes. Now, in phase two, they did say that they were looking at the crafting table because, you know, right now when you craft, say if you want to craft the M4, right, the rolls are really, really low. So they want to make it worth you can craft them, but they also don't want this to be a crafting game where all you do is sit at a table and you hope for the best rolls. So like you're playing the jackpot, right? Well, crafting, they are going to be looking at the crafting min and max, and that will be in phase two. So this is one of the changes in phase two. Another big thing that they did mention was for all of you PvP players in the Division 2, they want to increase the time to kill because the time to kill is super fast right now and it's not fun for a lot of players. So they want to increase it. So I'm assuming the amount of damage players take, the amount of damage we take from different skills, from weapons, might be reduced to increase that time to kill in PvP to let people make those counter plays and enjoy that type of gameplay that a lot of people enjoyed in the past. And currently, I don't really know too many people who are really loving PvP. But if you are loving PvP, let me know in the comment section. Now, the final thing I did want to get into is they are changing how you get exotics, or they're making it a little bit more clear on how you get exotics. So let's look at this graph right here. So right off the bat, we can see we see exotics availability at the very top, and then we have unique source and general sources. So unique source is specific to an exotic, and what that means is that is going to be something like the raid exotic. So currently, the Eagle Bear can only be getting from the raid, and that will stay like that. We also have exotics that come from blueprints initially, and then they are added to the target loot pool. So that would be something like the Nemesis, the Liberty, or even the Chatterbox. You find the pieces, you get the blueprint, you can craft it, and then you can also find it in the general sources. So those items, you have to get the blueprints first and then they'll go into general sources. So what are general sources? Well, the way to get these, to get any exotics like that, like the Chameleon, to get the Sweet Dreams, exotics like that, you can go to the targeted loot for the exotic type. So that would mean you would go farm for shotguns if you were looking for the Sweet Dreams. If you were looking for the Chameleon, you would go to ARs. Also, they are adding all of these exotics into the heroic and legendary final bosses. So another way for you guys to get these, they also are adding them to the raid bosses weekly. So all the raid bosses will have a chance of dropping all of these exotics. And then exotic caches will also have a chance of dropping all of these. Now, one thing you need to know is all the Warlords of New York exotics, like the Lady Death, the Bullet King, all of those are going to be added to general sources in Title Update 10. So it's going to be another way for you guys to farm for these. You no longer will have to go farm mission over and over and over, or you no longer have to look for the Lady Death in the open world bosses in Warlords of New York. That will all be added to general sources, which you can find in targeted loot, heroic legendary final bosses, raid bosses, or you can have a chance of getting from exotic caches like that exotic weekly project that I told you guys about. Now, a thing you guys need to remember is unique source is the seasonal reward track. So if you want to get a new specific exotic that comes out on a seasonal, you have to unlock it on the seasonal track first, and then it's added to the general sources. So that's something that you guys need to remember that too. So from general sources after unlocking on seasonal tracks. So like the mask, the coyote mask, that was a seasonal item. Once you unlocked it, then you could get it from Coyote on the mission itself, but they're changing that. You do not only have to get it from the mission itself, from you can also get it from Targeted Loot. Then this is all going to Title Update 10. So a lot of ways for you guys to get exotics. For everybody who said, you know what, it's really hard to get these exotics, to even upgrade my exotics to make them more powerful. But the great thing about this is, for all of you who are also saying it's not worth it, they are changing that too. So in Title Update 10 Phase 2, they are going to be working on the exotics to make them feel more powerful and make people want to use them more. The final thing I want to go over is they did say they are looking at to increase the time to kill in PvP. So in Phase 1, we should see some changes to the amount of damage that players take against other players. So hopefully the increased time to kill in PvP is increased and people enjoy PvP again, because I know a lot of people just aren't enjoying it right now. And I think that's pretty much it. I think I covered everything. They are going to have a full list of the PTS patch notes for Title Update 10 Phase 1. They said if it's not out on Thursday, then it will be out on Friday when the PTS goes live. So I will be covering that, and I will be playing the PTS on PC. I'll be testing out the new exotics, as they will give, they're giving the PTS will have access to the new exotics that are coming from Raid 2. They will also have access to the new gear sets. So all of that, I will have, I'll try to get you guys gameplay of it so you guys can see it in action and we could talk about it on this channel. So hopefully you guys are still enjoying the Division 2 content. I know I've been out of the loop a little bit. I just made it to Miami, Florida. I got my setup set up. So we should be continuing on with the videos, and hopefully everything continues on. I want to say thank you guys to everybody who is actually supporting this channel. Remember, we have a memberships on here. That's a great way to support this channel. If you guys enjoy watching Division 2 content, make sure you guys hit the subscribe button, turn the notification bell on, so when I release a video, you guys get notified. And I will continue to bring you guys Let's Play from Last of Us. The game is amazing. I haven't been able to play it since I moved, but I will continue that series. And we'll be playing a lot on this channel. So hopefully you guys are ready for the ride. Enjoy the multiple content, and well, I'll see you guys in the next one. Until then, nothing but skills is out.